Hi, today we are going to see how to enable caching in Spring project. For that we will go to File, go to New and create a Spring Starter project. And name, let's provide the name of the project, Enable Caching Demo. And description, to maintain cache demo. And I'm going to provide the group name as com.sumit and the package name as com.sumit.playjava. Sumit.playjava. And click on Next. Here we want only web to see the caching and dev tools to load things at runtime. So our project is starting. Let's go to the pom.xml file. And in the pom.xml file, I'm going to change the version to some previous versions like 2.1.0 because these are the stable versions. And click on save. And let me go to our Java class and create a Java class inside this package, that is com.sumit.playjava. I'm going to create a class. Let's provide the name of the class as controller, that is my controller, because we are going to create a controller. And we will create a controller and we will see whether the things are coming from cache or not. For that, first create a controller only and let's run things at the usual way. So I provide annotated with @ rest controller to mark it as a controller, and I am providing a get mapping. So it will provide the data through get method, and this is the URL, that is check cache. And let me provide the name of the method as public string check cache. Inside this I'm just going to return a string, so just return hello user, and I'm going to print some data here. So let's print sysout, this is system.out.println, and inside this I'm just going to print user data, and this much is fine. So whenever the things will not come from cache, it will go inside the method and it will print user data through system.out.println, and every time it will come here if the things are not cached. So let me run this application as Spring Boot. So our Spring project is starting, and see, it has started at port 8080. And let's go to our browser. So localhost 8080 is the port and the URL is check cache. Let me provide one slash also here. Click on save and let me just copy this. Click on save. And since we have provided DevTools, so no need to restart the server. It will load it at runtime only. And I'm providing here localhost slash check cache. See, hello user came. And when we will go to our console, see, user data got printed. And let me hit this URL few more times, 2, 3, 4 times. See, 4 times the user data is printing, because every time it is going to our code and getting data by executing the code, it is not getting data through cache. So we will see how to enable cache so that every time the code won't execute and it will be returned from the cache only. For that, first thing we need to do is to enable cache on the class. That is, on the class level we need to provide this annotation, that is enable caching. Second thing we need to provide, wherever we want things to be cached, we need to provide using annotation @cacheable. And the cacheable, we need to also provide the name of the key which needs to store the cache data. So let's provide the key as user info. So through these two annotations only, our data will be cached. So our project has started. Let me clear the console. Now after caching, let's hit this URL. See, first time it will go and it will print the data, because first time it will execute the code and store the things in cache. After that, hit few more times. See, I've hit few more times, but still only one data is there because the things are coming from cache only to the browser. Let me hit few more times. Let me just do the refresh through here also so that you can see that I am actually hitting the browser. See, but it has executed only one time, and after that the things are coming from cache only. So in this way we can maintain the cache in our Spring application. That is, first by enabling cache through @enablecaching annotation. And second thing, wherever you want the data to be cached, we need to provide this annotation, that is @cacheable, with a key to store the data. And this will provide cache annotation where you want data to be cached. So in this way we can maintain cache in Spring. You can check out some more tutorials I have made on Spring in our channel, that is Play Java. Thank you all for watching my video.